I wanted to talk about the rights of who we are now as persons. And it is not getting good because we have these Google circles now. I'm there with this Google account and I'm understanding it has this plus thing. And in each person, the way it works is each person on the plus account can go in and snag this one and snag that one and snag the other and keep them and consolidate them in a portfolio quite quickly. So here we are online. We are being persons normal, and here we are being captured in somebody's little filter of file. So just as you want, I want to capture all of my greatest baseball players, and there they are, and they're in a file. Now I'm capturing the persons that I don't like. I'm putting them in a file. Very dangerous for those persons. So now what do we do? Because one person, it only takes one person in that instance, one person with a vendetta, and it could be a vendetta wrong, a vendetta in the air, a vendetta incorrect. This one person can put you in a file called this Google Plus circle. And in this Google Plus circle, this person can hurt you. He or she can absolutely kill you. Then you put persons in the file and kill them, all those persons in the file. Make a direct action to their deaths. So I'm not really liking this deal. It's quite a dangerous exposure. Now, when I'm talking specifically, now we'll go back to these property owners with their supposed myriad fortunes on the paper alone. Their fortunes on the paper alone. They own a fortune on the loan, yes. Very few of them actually own their houses complete and outright. Very few are really in the money there. So let's get over this one. And yet they are still stomping on the towns and the villages and owning these little typical juristats. They're still stomping on the villages and owning them. How does this happen? How is this allowed? Even if they own the property and outright, there is no reason for them to have slumlords going on. Keeping people and making them pay for slum accommodations. There is absolutely not an agreement with the local governments or the grand governments, the large governments of the Europe to back any landlord or property owner when they are keeping persons and making them pay in a slumlord accommodations. Now this includes taking advantage of woofers. They're called woofers, they're persons who work properties. This includes taking advantage of caretakers. This includes caretakers are persons who look after and garden also, the jardiniers. When these persons are there continuing with the property and in some fashion to not destroy it as best they can, it does not qualify a money from those persons. It does not qualify that the woofer pays. It does not qualify that the retreat person. It does not qualify that the person that is the jardiniere, the person who's caretaker living there in that particular house. It is in a disagreeable, that it is needing the restoration. It does not qualify that property owner any allowance and ask for money. It never gives them the right to ask for money. There are agreements when the house is actually in working order. And there are agreements when the house falls out of working order. Once the house falls out of working order and it is no longer rentable, then there is no money that is given from the renter, the letter to the property owner. That's what happens. If the house falls away from storms, tempests, disrepairs, the roofings, the scaffoldings, not the scaffolding, but the roofings and the holes and the leaks, if these things are going on, and they're going on, and the property owner doesn't care, they just want this money extra to pay the loan, because for some reason, they think they own the whole house and the person inside. They don't. They do not own the person inside, they do not own the house. Alright? Just forget it. Way too many of you are just running around with this ramps on your loan own. You know, your loan own. I'm really tired of the disrespect. Disrespect. Person to person. Based upon a house owning. This extra class of a house own. I mean, it's retarded. It's a retarded group of persons. They call themselves into this class. How the heck did this happen, first of all? How the heck did this ramp up to like this? I got it. Keep populating, keep having the children. That's how it happened. Exactly how it happened. More and more and more children. Keep having more children. That's how it happened. Just recreating the Victorian times. That's all you're doing. Yeah, where what? Half the population has to be the coal miners? This is where it is now. And who does this support? Who does this support? Do you think you have the wealth? Do you think you have the property? It's just a piece of paper. It's just a piece of paper. You can't pay that property tax. It's gone. It's very simple. Alright, so, when I find that there are local persons that are in agreement to help property owners aggravate, hurt, humiliate, intimidate a person residing within the house that is a slum house, They are also included in the actions against. And that is not a good inclusion to be in. That puts them in the wrong. Once they are put in the wrong, that means they are under the excavations also for a payment. For a payment for what they have done. So if they are found guilty, to be actions against the person who is residing in these slum houses. The persons who have not paid because the house is disreputable and falling apart and under needing repairs. If the persons have retaliated against, they are also culpable. They are on the list also aside, right there with the property owner. They're added to the list, and this includes the Marie of the village. This includes anybody else who has been in cohorts with him. Yeah, we're talking human rights here. Human rights, and they are human rights that have been fraught. Human rights. Once you have reached a level and you have hurt other human beings for your particular fancy of of this Google bubble thing that you got going on, keeping me in some kind of a Google bubble there. No. The Google bubble goes also back to you. You will also be captured and sent into these persons. These persons have aggregated against persons. These persons have intimidated others. These persons have intimidated others living in houses of disrepair. You will be listed. You want a law after you? A law after you will be public. It will be public. Publicity forever, the rest of your life. On the internet. It's not going away. Do unto others as they do to you. What is this? You're going back to God or something? The justification for your little financing of the bank? It's a bank is winning always. It's all bankers. It's the bank who's winning their percentage. It's all it is. It's a bank up there. It's the board of directors on the bank. And then the bank that's public. And then it's the stockholders. That's all it is. So then we're looking right there at the financial market. Oh, the bank is failing today. And so the EU is going to throw another 300 million in. Just like this, made up money. 300 million. It's not enough today? Well, 3 days later, we have 600. Don't you remember how easy it is to write this check? So as the persons are here, fighting in the coal mines of Victorian states, right here, right now, why bother when the EU is writing the check for 600 million when the bank is failing? Who is the enemy here? Who is a true enemy? Fighting the wrong persons. Fighting the wrong persons. I don't need this. I have the neighbor now having just inordinate amount. Just the rudest persons ever. Show up in the car. Show up in the car and yell and scream and honk and honk and honk for payment for something. Who do these persons think they are? How dare they? That is going out there. Those two persons that showed up. That is going out there right now. They were absolutely wrong. You don't go to the person's house and demand payment like this. I know I said I meander in nihilism, but that is not what I meant. I didn't mean lawlessness everywhere. Meander is just in the mind, in the place of, in the thinking of it. It's a philosophy. I didn't want this philosophy live here. This lawlessness, give me the money now, honk, 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 for half an hour with the stupid little car. Yeah, so they're bubbled. There's another Google bubble to those two. So what am I solving here? The true enemy is the EU. It is the bailout for the banks always, no matter. All the fights, all these little fights, the payments here, the payments there. The bankers always are winning. The finance of the stock market, the persons who are placing the trades are always winning. As long as they take the right side, long or short, put or call, as long as they are winning. In that moment only, and that's 50% of a chance. So we have the bailout of the 600 millions, the 300 million here extra, and we have a 50% chance of those who are actually in the trading, the day tradings, to actually make a profit. And even that is high. even that is high because of the directness of up and down. That just, yeah, the scandal is the thought that you're going to make the 50% of that 900 million. That is the scandal of it. You'll never make that. You'll never make that. So they're throwing the money away for persons that maybe are going to make what? 7 or 8%? 7 or 8% on a good day? Yow. 7 or 8% on a good day. That's what we're doing here. Persons are beating up, fighting in the streets. For someone sitting at home going, I'm going to push my internet brokerage button for my 7 or 8% in hope. Oh, crud! 16% lost? No. No. How do I bail out these banks? How do I bail out these banks? Well, not with the money from me. Not with the money from me. I'm never going to trade those suckers. Not ever. Not ever. So the money. The money to bail out the banks. That's what it all goes down to, doesn't it? The EU keeps writing the check. It will not have a depression. 1930s, 1926, if you want to say it happened then. It will not have a depression, 1929 crash. They refuse. They refuse. They think it is wonderful to just go pluck. We'll just digital the money happy to everybody that is a bank that has a HSBC, that has that other one that's so amazing. Oh my gosh, it starts with that B. Oh my gosh. Anything. These stupid British banks. Just say British banks. Just all full stop. British banks getting bailed out. All the while, slum lords are running rampant. And being protected because they purchase property. Being protected by local jurisdictions because they purchase property. Property that is just a goddamn hellhole. On the list. You're on the list. Forever. That Google bubble. You'll stay in that circle, pal. The rest of your life. 4 years not giving me money. 4 years. 4 years I have to go out here and steal off the neighbor's goddamn garden floor his apples. 4 years. I have to go and take the pears out of the trees from the cows. 4 years. What do you call it? Theft. I have been thieved. I have been thieved by this local government. I asked for money for my art. I asked for money for the fact that I have even written another government version, a backup version for any government in the world, all the governments of the world to follow through. In the case of chaos, in the case of gosh damn bank finance disrupt of everything, I have the backup system. Where is my money for that? I wrote it and it's on my goddamn website. Where is my money for that? Where is my money for the goddamn perpetual motion? Where is my money for that one? How dare you? How dare you do this to any goddamn human? How dare you leave that statue in the village? How dare you have that on the drive-by for a little child to see? How dare you? The woman martyred with a beam through her back? How dare you? So how does this help? Google bubble. So how do we close this EU from feeding it and let this sucker crash as it's supposed to in normal? If it's cheating, it's obviously cheating. I'm not going to know why I put the C in there. It is cheating. The EU is cheating. It cannot be the bailouts any longer, make up money. Oh. Give them, oh my gosh. It was only 16. Today I'll go in and maybe I'll get my 8% back tomorrow. You know, only 16. Maybe tomorrow, you know. It's just that the little greed high, you know. Give those traders an extra greed high. That's all you're doing with your little extra throw-in of the cash of the bailout of the banks. Is the extra little greed high for the so few that are out there trading at all. Is the extra greed high. Keep them floating, you know, keep this gosh damn, let the sucker crash. That is its life. It lives and it dies. And that is the real true market. It lives and it dies. And when you've gone into market protectionism, it is a fail. It is an absolute cheat. So when you're cheating the system, when you're cheating the actual commerce system, you're cheating everyone. You're cheating everyone. Because you're not the truth any longer. You're not the truth any longer. It's not the truth in economy, is it? It's not the truth in economy. It's just like, oh my gosh, it's a bad day. 300 million. It's a bad day. The truth in economy is that 300 million never shows up. And it goes to zero. That is the truth in economy. And that is a failed government. A failed economy. Right then and there. And that's the fix. And then we find the fix. Right there. I've given it. I've given the government out there. You make another one. You make another one. You pay the persons first. You pay everybody on this planet first. You pay them yearly. They get this 20 stupid goddamn thousand every year. They're not allowed to save it unless they put it back into the market. 20,000. For their eating and their housing. And that includes their work that pays them for their work. That is their work payment for the normal manual labor. It was a very simple system. It's made up money anyway. It's all made up money. It's all digital made up. It's just made up digital goddamn money. There is no gold qualifying any of it this longer, to this degree, to this amount. There's no gold spire this high any longer. There's no ruby collection. There's no diamond collection spire this high that goes into these trillions. Get over it. You cannot add up every asset in the world and say that you have it. It is spired too high. We are just dealing with 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And those little cut and paste places, that is all is going on here in the financial market. That is all it is. It's a digital currency, pluck and play where you want to put it. Now it's not fair. The only fairness is to be free and give everybody, even the jerks that you hate the most, the 20,000 a year. And they have to work. They have to have some kind of work. Now, because they are there, they're receiving this on the first of every year, and it's enough to feed their families, it's enough to pay for these mortgages. It still continues the supply. You can still have your stock market play game, Mr. and Mrs. EU, who want to day trade. You can still have it. You can still play your 7 and 8s. You can still wish and dream you're going to get your 7 and 8s. You can keep going there all you want. But it has a life to deserve also to zero. It has a life also, freedom to deserve to zero. And that is life. That is the way it goes on. Your little frickin' corn crops fail, it goes to zero. That is the way it goes. You don't get bailed out. It goes to zero. Now, when you're having all of this happen, you're having this commerce market failing, you're having the 20,000, it does not matter, because at the end of the year, everybody has a chance. If you have the 18,000 in your account still, if you have 18,000 spent and you have 2,000 left that you have not spent, you can put this 2,000 into the market. And so the little market that was at zero gets a little bailout of 2,000 from that one person. That one person. And so it goes on, it goes on, it goes on, it goes on. And so the little market gets propped up every year again, doesn't it? So it is a no failing system, and I have fixed it. And it is there, and it's on my stupid goddamn website. All right? So, I wrote it. So I deserve to be paid. You understand?